nature. The last presentation for the harvest policy is an update on where we are on the development of MSE, or a management strategy evaluation. And this is a material that is included in page 78 of the Blue Book and page 281 of the RORA. So this figure is actually quite complex, but it has the same level of complexity that we go every year when we go through an annual assessment and management. This is why we are here, and this is what we do every year. Effectively, it's the current framework, and it's called, in fisheries management lingo, it's called sort of the best assessment approach, or the best annual assessment approach. I will not describe this in much detail. You have it in the Blue Book. Each year, basically, we construct a coastwide data set based on data from all of the areas. This is just grouping, for example, all of Area 2, all of Area 3, all of Area 4. We construct some coastwide data set. We estimate through the stock assessment estimates of eBio and explorable biomass, and also of spawning biomass. Based on those, and based on where we estimate we are with respect to the level of spawning biomass relative to unfished, we actually feed into this harvest control rule, and we determine what the target harvest rate is going to be for the next year. Once we determine what the target rate is going to be for each area, we go and calculate different things such as total CUI, fishery CUI. Eventually, the staff catch limit recommendations are put forward at the different, and we come to these types of meetings like such as now, and then the conference board and PAR have their own sets of recommendations, and eventually, based on those three types of recommendations, we arrive at a commission decision, we adopt catch limits, and we repeat the process. So as you can see, in each of these different levels, there is the potential for uncertainty, bias, and misspecification of the process. It's just a fact of life, and it happens in every fishery. And there, in recent time, there has been an alternative approach to fisheries management that focused on a different set of assumptions, but it's actually trying to take into account formally different uncertainties, bias, and potential misspecifications that the assessment process may have. This is called a management procedure, or a management strategy, or management strategy evaluation, depending on of who is actually doing the work. Effectively, what it relies on at the core is something that is called an operating model, which is our best depiction of what nature is out there. The fact is that with the current and traditional approach, we never know what is reality out there. We just get an estimate of it, and each year that thing can be revised. And we do not know, or may not late, where we were. This approach operates in a different way. It actually builds something that is like nature on a computer. It is complicated, but we know what nature in the computer is. And then that thing is basically what is called the operating model. And from there, we can actually sample from that nature that is in the computer in the same way that we sample the nature. And so that way, we actually know what the proper answer is, and now we can see how far off we get with our current way of sampling, assessing, or making management decisions in a way that we cannot do with the real nature out there. So this entails having an operating model, as I mentioned, and I will go into detail later, and then sample from it. Then we get some kind of management model that may involve an assessment or not. And then effectively, we make some catch limit recommendations or quotas or different types of removals that affect the nature in the computer. We cycle this thing over time, just as we cannot do in nature. We only get one realization of nature. With this thing, we can explore many different ones. We get a summary model that says how far off we got if we follow these models. And eventually, based on that, we can actually compare different management alternatives and see which one works well and which ones work bad, if you will. So most of the goal of MSE is not an optimality. It's almost never to find the optimal way of managing a stock. It's rather to weed out the ones that can produce bad outcomes on the computer, if you will. You produce bad outputs in the computer, they are most likely hopeless in reality. So this MSC approach is not unique of a single fishery or even a couple of fisheries. There have been an increased number of examples of its use across the world, including the Whaling Commission, different species in South Africa and Australia, New Zealand, Namibia, and also one of the most ambitious ones probably on the Commission for the Conservation of Southern Bluefin Tuna that has been in the development for quite some time. There are also some close relatives, if you will, of halibut in terms of its proximity and type of fishery. In Canada, is also work going on this topic. So what are the advantages of the of this approach, the MSC approach or the management procedure approach over the conventional yearly assessment approach, is that it depends more directly on monitoring and feedback rather than being each year going through this process of potentially revisions of estimates of an assessment. Uses decision rules that are driven by the data, as I said, was exactly what I just said before, and allow us to formally evaluate different management strategies through a formal evaluation process rather than just discounting them or not based on our beliefs or our experience. So we can actually formally evaluate different assumptions of biology, fishing process, and how we gather data. The decision rules, for example, on how we set the catch limits or what the catch limits might be, are based typically on simple rules or simple calculations, even if the procedures that are actually used to derive to those decision rules or to see if those decision rules are robust are evaluated to a pretty complex system of simulations. As a quick example, a catch limit rule that, for example, now is actually based on a best estimate of explorable biomass, a target harvest rate mediated by the level of spawning biomass. In this case, a catch rule can be much more simple. And it will be, for example, to adjust catch limits based on trends in the weight per unit of effort. So this is the equation, so don't you have it there, don't worry about it too much. It's just a matter of, for example, you can expect to calculate or to derive catch limits based straight on weight per unit of effort, for example, of the survey or of the commercial fishery. That is in years, or if you estimate, like in this case, a trend of several years of the WPUE coming down, then the catch limits for that year will be derived to come down. If the WPUE trend is actually flat, then the catch limits should be flat. If the WPUE is increasing, then the catch limits should be recommended to go up. So it's very simple, straightforward. You just need to make sure that it's robust to the kind of fishery you have and where it will fail. That's basically what you are trying to do with this exercise. So as I said, it's a complex simulation exercise. I will be very brief here, but you have more detail in the document and involves effectively three components. One is the conditioning component, which is to take that model of nature in the computer and to make sure that it's not something that doesn't have any relationship with what we know of halibut per se. So to do so, we need to actually make sure that it's consistent with historic data. That is what is called a conditioning of the operating model. Why this is important is because it needs to be consistent so that we can derive estimates of stock size that are consistent to what we saw in history and what could be seen in the future, and also that are consistent with the catches that have been taken from the stock in the historical sense. The next step, or the consecutive step, is, if you will, is the projection component that takes that that nature, the operating model, and then we follow a cycle that could be followed each year. That is what we take the catches, we sample our population, and for example, age distribution of the catches, that's what is here. The process can be mediated or not by an assessment model as well. We derive different statistics on the status of the stock, like for example, harvest rates, numbers, level of spawning biomass, and then we make our management decisions. Eventually, in that projection component, this is where the action happens, and the evaluation component is the one that we summarize what we saw. Did we actually meet our targets? Did we not? Where did we fail? How did we fail? And then eventually, is basically what allows to evaluate different types of management alternatives. The operating model, and I will not go into the details itself, as I said, is our best depiction of reality under different assumed processes. For example, just to go over a few, it would be like has to include dynamics of both the population and the fishery, but it can also involve alternative hypotheses. For example, do we model or not the spatial structure? Is it relevant or not to the dynamics? Can we use different types of migration scenarios within the areas? Well, all those things are things that are included in the operating model. The projection component, as I say, is like where the core of the action happens. And I just explained it before, so I will not explain it further here. What I would like to say is that typically for most MSCs that have been conducted or under development for other fisheries, there's significant stakeholder input in the both in the definition of the operating model, that is what the stakeholders want to see be model or would expect to see model as the dynamics of nature, but also with regards to what types of management models could be used. This is typically important to have the stakeholder buy into the whole process, otherwise this thing can become a simulation exercise that is detached from the actual reality of the fishery and may have little chances of being implemented. The evaluation component is very straightforward, so I will not go into that. It's just a way of summarizing different combinations of operating models and management strategies. So the typical steps on how one go about testing a management procedure or going through a process of management strategy evaluation involves these steps here. They are in order here. They typically follow this order, but they can be iteratively revisited as new information comes along, new ideas or interactions with people involved in this. But typically involves defining first the objectives and the performance metrics of the whole exercise. Involve also the developing of different candidate harvest strategies that we want to look at and related control rules. Then you can have the development of those operating models or models of nature and condition them to historic data. And then eventually when you have that in place, you can actually go about and simulate those candidate harvest strategies. Eventually you can select one or a set that works well and weed out the ones that work bad. And if everything goes well and leads to eventual implementation of the harvest strategy. So now we move into the conditioning. That is like to make sure that the operating model that you have or the set of operating models are consistent with nature. And for Halibut, we have different sets of data. For example, this is the data that is used in the recent stock assessments. This is from 96 to 2010. So we have information on removals and the different components of it. We have information on abundance indices, both commercial WPUE and survey WPUE. We have information on age compositions and on mean length at age. So this is the type of information and the time period that is used for the most recent stock assessments and the assumptions that go in those recent stock assessments, and Steven is going to go after that with the talk. In the case for the model that I'm using for the MSC, the data that is used is actually a broader set of data going back to the beginning of the fishery in 1988 in terms of total removals. As you see, there's more data than we currently use for the recent stock assessment. And the reason why is that is because the different characteristics of the recent stock assessment and the model that is being used in this case to condition the model, and also the different quality of the data. So for example, in this case, the most recent assessment has to parse out the commercial, sex composition of the commercial catch, and it uses the survey, so it needs the survey to do so. This model does not need that, so it doesn't use it. It has caveats, however. The conditioning of the model is that the data used for that condition is the further back we go in time. Of course, the spatial resolution of it will change. It may not now show data proportional to abundance like we do now, for example, with the survey, but it has the other compromise, which is takes into account dynamics going way back in time. So the data quality degrades as we go back in time, but this is a compromise with regard to the data quality and the processes it's informing. In terms of removals, again, the different components that are fed, in this case, into the recent stock assessments adding to the conditioning model, just trying to take into account dynamics earlier in time in the fishery. In terms of the fit of the conditioning model, this is basically how the model is statistically fit to the data, just to make sure that it's actually consistent with it. So they can depict the simulations for the strategy evaluation itself. So what we have here, for example, are commercial age compositions. The sexes are combined in this case. We don't have the parsing out of the data for of the sexes for the commercial catch even at present, but this is the way that is actually inputted in the model, and the model works with them as such. So that's the data in gray. In red is actually the lines, the feeding lines. And again, the feed to this data is done by Stock Synthesis, which is a stock assessment platform that has been used widely by NOAA and also by other agencies in the US and across the world. In terms of surveys age composition by sex, we have here between 1997 to 2010 for females and males. Again, the data and the fit, so it's fitting to the age composition reasonably well. It's capturing that, those dynamics. In terms of the commercial WPUE, again, this includes WPUE for data going back in time into the early 1900s. What we see here is the raw estimate of CPUE, and here are just the variability associated with it. And in blue, it's not smoother, but it's the model fit to the data. Again, as I mentioned before, the further back in time, you have to make different assumptions about the selectivity and catchability of those fisheries, because they most likely were different to more recent ones when the fishery had expanded to all of the areas. In terms of the fit to the survey CPUE, that's basically what that blue line shows there. And it also estimates the time series of recruitment. So that's basically, not enough data there to estimate it, or in recent years, not enough data, but you see quite a bit of variability. And this variability and the actual levels are actually very similar to an earlier operating model that was developed about April of this year, but it had different types of assumptions on it, so it was decided to continue with the stock synthesis approach, but the results are very similar. In terms of the variability for each recruitment year, that's what is being shown here, and it is consistent with historical assessments conducted at the Commission that shown some of the largest cohorts entering the fishery in 1977 and 1987, and suggests also some other intermediate cohorts and different levels of recruitment in different times. The model also produces estimates of total biomass. In this case, it's total biomass age 8 and older. And the trends, I mean, the level of the total biomass is actually similar. This is for about year 2000 or 1996 to 2006. So the level is up here for this conditioning model, and brown lines here are the different fits of the recent stock assessment as the year went by. So the level and trend of those biomass is similar at the beginning of the series, but then there's a departure in the trends. So this conditioning model estimates a continuing decline in total bio, and the recent assessments estimate an increase. There's ongoing work on the potential effects of different assumptions on selectivity and survey catchability in the conditioning model and in this model, and those are being evaluated because they seem to have an effect on these different trends. This is the fit to the female spawning biomass and the variability associated with it. And again, something similar. This comparison is effectively being done so that to see if the condition model is actually similar or not with past assessments that were done by the Commission. So it's similar to the level and to the increase of assessments done in the beginning 2000, and also with the projections derived from those assessments. But it has some differences again on the later few years between the recent stock assessment and the conditioning model. Those are the projections for the recent models. Those are the projections for historical assessments. So again, the goal of this model is not to provide necessarily the best estimate of biomass now or its trend, but it has to be consistent with the history of the fishery for the exercise to be meaningful. And an illustration of that and how we how this model is used to for the simulation part of the exercise is just to take those estimates that we have here and not necessarily use the mean values of those estimates or for those values, but to include the variability associated with those estimates. For example, from that variability, in this case only 4 samples, and under one set of assumptions, which is like in this case selectivity at age and constant soil catchability, and then resample from them, generate another set of estimates of biomass trend, resample from them, and in each case see what is the performance of management strategies under those different resamplings of that reality in the computer. So very quickly where we are now, and again this is in the RARA report and Blue Book, I mentioned that part of the goal is to define objectives and performance metrics. So far we have objectives and performance metrics only from the status quo harvest strategies, that is we can go about and test how the current harvest strategy performs, but still the level and type of stakeholder participation need to be discussed and determined. In terms of the development of candidate harvest strategies and harvest control rules, the candidates, the current candidates need to be discussed and expanded to proceed. And the development of operating models and their conditioning to historic data is actively ongoing, and some of the results is what you saw in the previous slides. And then into the next set of steps, which is actually the time-consuming and computer-intensive phase of simulation test of those models, selecting what harvest strategies work well and work not well, and potential implementations of different harvest strategies. All of those are awaiting previous steps. In terms of the input needed for the MSC, part of it are the objectives that the MSC should achieve. That is, are we mainly trying to see if the current harvest strategy is robust uncertainty, or are there other objectives that we may want to look at, like simpler strategies or alternative strategies? Then we need to decide what the performance indicators are we going to use. Is are we going to look at changes relative to a minimum biomass? Are we going to look at the level of bias that could affect the performance of different strategies, for example? Or and also include the and discuss what type of uncertainty should be considered, that is uncertainties in the quantities itself, uncertainties in the implementation of management. Those are things that are still need to be discussed. And that's the last I have.
Thanks, Juan. Thank you for your patience sitting through some fairly long and complicated presentations. Let's take a 15-minute break and come back at 10:45, please.
Just like data set now matches the way we use the survey WPU industry.